One of the more interesting properties of our universe is the existence of antimatter. Antimatter is simply matter that merely has the opposite electrical charge. Other than that, it behaves in an identical manner to normal matter, so far as we know, and would, if you had enough of it, be able to form atoms, planets, and even aliens. Other than the famous effect of antimatter and matter mutually annihilating when they come into contact with each other, there is nothing special about the material other than, in our world of predominantly normal matter, it is very expensive to create, often claimed to be the most expensive stuff on Earth, and only individual atoms of antimatter have ever been made, most interestingly when a nucleus of antihelium was created. But we don't see atoms of it, so far as we know, in the universe, despite the prediction that the Big Bang should have created antimatter in equal parts to normal matter. The universe literally should have annihilated itself just after the Big Bang. Clearly, it did not. This has led to one of the great mysteries of physics, the asymmetry of matter and antimatter. The current thinking there is that somehow the Big Bang produced just a little bit more matter than antimatter, and most of what the creation of the universe resulted in was annihilated. And our matter is just the remnants. But new research by M. Agostini and colleagues using a detector in Italy, link in the description below, may be close to solving the question by looking for a peculiar form of radioactive decay that, if it exists, it would go a long way in explaining the asymmetry. But antimatter isn't entirely banned in nature. Individual positrons, the electron's antiparticle, are seen in nature, particularly positrons produced by radioactivity. But there is one mysterious example of positron creation that is absolutely mind-blowing in the sheer amount of antiparticles it produces. It's called an antimatter fountain, and at least one has been found near the center of the Milky Way. It was first observed in 1997 by the Compton Gamma Ray Observatory by surprised scientists who weren't expecting to see matter-antimatter annihilation radiation in the Milky Way. But there it was, on an enormous scale stretching as far as 3,500 light-years from the source. Not a lot is known about the source of the positrons. One idea is that exploding stars in star-forming regions might produce them, and another is that they are produced in the jets of black holes, but it's hard to imagine any of those sources creating so many antiparticles. The estimates are as much as the equivalent of 15 billion tons of positrons a second are being created and thrown out of the center of the galaxy, and a second mystery is how enough of them avoid encountering normal matter and annihilation to stretch so far out of the galaxy. I've always thought that the mysterious antimatter fountain never quite got its due. Articles and papers on it are sparse, but in my opinion, it was one of Compton's more interesting discoveries. It's also probably one of the areas of the galaxy that you'd most want to avoid, lest you get annihilated by positrons. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently imagining items that could be made from antimatter. I have invented the anti-donut, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.